All right, guys, welcome back. I'm gonna do some poppers. And so I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of these peppers. I'm gonna slice them in half and put this cream cheese, some pulled pork across it, and a little bit of barbecue sauce, a barbecue rub rather, not sauce, rub, and some wrap them in bacon. And so I'll show you that process as I go. So let's get started. Got them all cooked. I got them all cut, and now I'm gonna take all the middles out of them and start putting them together. And I'll show you that when I get to that point. But so we'll continue on, and I'll show you the next step. All right, I'll show you what I'm doing. I'm taking the middle out of all of these. So I'm just using a spoon to just scrape out the seeds and this middle meat out of these. And gotta be kind of gentle so that you don't tear them or punch holes in them. And so get all of this out of here. Then once I'm done with this, I'm going to wash them all just to kind of be sure that I got most everything out of here and they're rinsed off. And that'll be the next step, is to put this into it. But I just wanted to show you this little this process. You just cut them in half and just dig this out of here. Pretty well got that one, I think. And one more. I'll show you one more. Just dig this out of here. This is where the heat's at from everything I'm seeing and reading. I'm not real much on peppers myself. And so, anyway, with a spoon.
I don't have the picture.
It's still rolling. And so they look something like that. And this is everything that was out of the middle of them. There's all the ones I'm going to make like that. And so the next step is I'm going to rinse them and we'll come back. Okay. All cored out and rinsed. So now we'll put the cream cheese into them. Cream cheese, and we shall move on to the next step. So I'll come back and I'll show you a little bit of that also. Okay, all of them have the cream cheese in them now, and the next step is what we're gonna do is I'm gonna put, again, like I said, some barbecue rub across the top of this. A little bit of the pulled pork I made the day before, or yesterday I finished it up, and then I'm going to wrap them in bacon. And so I'll show you the next step here as putting a bit of barbecue rub across these. Okay, so it's just a simple, whoop, a little heavy there. Just kind of light across the tops of them all. I think that'll do. All right, and it's the same one I used on the pulled pork, the sweet rub of mine, same one. And so now a little bit of pulled pork into the top of all of these. I'll show you that when I come back just a minute. Okay, a little bit of pulled pork into each of them. And between each step, always wash your hands, wash your utensils, do a lot of that just to help not cross-contaminate and anything. Always wash your hands. Wash your hands often and many times when you're cooking, no matter what you're cooking. And it's always good, safe practices to wash your hands as often as possible just to help keep things in a good way. And so now I'm going to wrap them in bacon, and when that's done, I'll show you that. In the meantime, I had started a fire, so come out to check, see how the fire's doing, up to about 250. And so we're good there on the fire. And I used the same. I still had quite a bit left from the pulled pork cook, and so there was still plenty of charcoal. I had some crumbs and stuff I took out of it when I put new in here. And so I put some of that on top. So plenty of charcoal. And yeah, our fire is looking good. Temperature is good. Get these poppers wrapped and we'll get them on here. Wrapped in bacon, ready to go to the grill. And so that was pretty quick. And we're ready to go to the grill now. And we'll just cook them from there. And we'll just keep an eye on them off and on. And from what I see from the other videos I've watched, they take maybe an hour, hour and a half. So that would put it, like, it's 2:30 now. So around 3:30 or 4, these ought to be ready. And I need to leave about 4:15, something like that, maybe. 4, something like that. And 4:30, I don't know, something like that. So we're good. So we're about 45, 50 minutes into the poppers. I just thought I'd show you a quick look. My temperature is right under 300, sailing along. I had it open a little bit. I had this cracked open a little bit. I just closed that back just to kind of back it down a little bit. But I'll show you what they look like. Oh yeah, looking good. Got to leave them alone a little longer. And yeah, it'll be ready in time for me to leave for the picnic. Hooray! About an hour and 15 minutes. My temperature creeped up to about 300, but it's fine there. Show you what they look like. About an hour. I'm about gonna take them off here. I think about 10 or 15 minutes. So I'll show you what we got. There we go. They look great. Looks pretty good for a first try. So yeah, success. Hope you guys like that. I know this is kind of a short one, but if you would like and subscribe, give me a comment, share. I'd appreciate that. I'm gonna have another shot of these when I take them off and one more look, so we'll have another look here just in a bit. All right guys, about an hour and a half, we're gonna take them off. Might have been a little long, maybe. No, maybe not. Take them inside. We'll have a look. We'll close this up. Let this start coming down off a temp. Oops, upside down. Oh well. Anyway, they're done. About an hour and a half. Might have went a little long, but they're done for now. And so that other clip previous to this, not sure if I'm going to add that yet. If I did, sorry about that. It was kind of a thought I had it turned off, but anyways, I know it was kind of a short cook, and hope you enjoyed that. Like, subscribe, comment, share, appreciate that, and talk to you later. Thanks, guys. Oh, man. I'm so mixed up. All right.